A very good morning to one and all children. Sai Ram. This is our EVS spirit. So today, what I am going to do, children? You all know? See, last session, teacher had done the explanation part of chapter number 12, Rules for Safety. Today, we are going to read the lesson and we are also going to complete the textual questions. So children, all of you, please open your EVS test book, children. New green tree. All of you keep the book ready on the table. Have you taken out the notebook? Yes, children. Is it ready on the table? Yes. Okay, now what we are going to do? Teacher is going to read the lesson and even you all are going to read along with teacher. I think now you all can read very well. So, you can read along with teacher. Right, children? So, now open page number 61. Page number 61, chapter number 12, Rules for Safety. Rules for Safety. I don't think you need any explanation because in the last session I had explained to you all the rules for safety, like what rules you should follow inside the house, outside the house, in the school and so on, right? So today I am not going to explain that, only the reading part will be done. Okay, children? Now, as you all know, the signal red, yellow and green. Red says stop, yellow ready to go and green says go. These are the three colors of the signal. This also you know. Right? Now we will start reading the lesson. Are you ready, children? See, you have to keep a pencil with you so that you can just, or you can with the finger, you can just keep on, you can just scroll round and just read along with teacher. Yes, children? Shall I start, children? Okay. Lesson number 12, Rules for Safety. There are rules that we must follow for our safety. We must follow these rules at home and outside. If we do not follow, what will happen? If we do not follow these rules, we can hurt ourselves and others. You may also get hurt. Same way, others may also get hurt if you do not follow the safety rules. So, to be on the safer side, always try to follow the safety rules. To be safe. Follow the safety rules to be safe. Right, children? Okay. Now, let us see the next. At home, that is, what safety rule should you follow at home? Do not play with fire. If you have to light a match or a candle, ask a grown-up to help you. That is, do not play with fire. If you have to light a match or a candle, ask a grown-up to help you. That is, you have to take the help of your father, mother, or any other elderly person from the family. You should not do it alone. You can take the help of your elder sister, brother. Okay, fine. Then, see, can you see this picture? On the last session also, I showed you how the child's mother is helping him to light the candle. Right, children? Okay. Same way, even you have to take the help of the elder. Now, next, we must not play with sharp things like knives and scissors. We should always sharpen our pencils with a sharpener and not with a knife or a blade. So what? We should always take the help of a sharpener to sharpen the pencil. We should not sharpen the pencil with blade or knife. Otherwise, you will get hurt. It is very dangerous. Now, the next. See, before we go to the next, you can see the picture. How the girl is sharpening the pencil with the help of a sharpener. That is the reason I told you, you all keep the sharpener in the pencil box, right? To sharpen the pencil. Now, we must not put our fingers into an open socket. We could get a shock. This also I told you last time. If the socket is open, you should not go and put your fingers. What will happen? You will get a bad shock. Okay, children? So, you should not play with that. You will think, "Arey, this is open. I can just put my finger into it." No, you should not do that. What will happen? You will get a bad shock. Now, next. See, here again in the picture you can see how the boy is trying to put his finger, but his father is stopping. He is telling, "Don't put your fingers, you will get a bad shock." The outside home. What are the safety rules to be followed outside home? We must cross a road at the zebra crossing. This also I had explained to you in the last session. We must always cross the road at the zebra crossing. You can see the white and black stripes on the road. So you should cross only at the zebra crossing. See, here you can see the zebra crossing, right? All those that boy and girl are trying to cross the road. This is how you have to follow the safety rules. When we cross the road, we must look into the right and then left and then again right before we cross the road. We must not run or play on the road. We must not run or play on the road. We should not play or run in the middle of the road. Right, children? Always first look at the right and then left and then again to the right before crossing the road. See, what these boys are doing, they are playing on the road. Is it correct? No. The car is coming. See, what will happen if you play on the road like this? You will meet with an accident, right? So, children, please avoid playing on the road. You can play only in the playground, not on the road. Okay. Now, we must always walk on the footpath and not on the road. We must never get on to a moving bus or get down from a moving bus. We must not lean out or put our hand out of a moving bus, car or train. This also you know, I need not explain to you. Only when the bus stops, you should board the bus or you should get down from the bus. The bus will stop at the bus stop. Then only you should get in or get down from the bus. You should never catch a moving bus. It's very dangerous. And you should not put your hands out of the moving bus, or you should always see that when the bus is moving, you should not put your hands out of the moving bus. It is very dangerous. Okay, children? See, you can see in this picture. See the boy, what he is doing? He is putting his hand out of the moving bus. This you should not do. Yes, children? Okay, so this is wrong. This is a wrong practice. Now, we will come with the textual questions. Okay, children? See, these questions have given you even in the worksheet form so that it will be easy for you to solve the worksheet also. Right, children? The same thing I have given you in the worksheet also. So, now first we will do in the test book. Right? We will try to complete this. Mark the sentences as true or not true. This is nothing but true or false. Right, children? If it is false, you will put a cross. If it is true, you will put a tick mark. Okay. Now, we must run across the road. Is it right or wrong? It is Wrong. You will put a cross. We must lean out of a moving bus. Is it correct? Wrong. We should sharpen our pencils with a blade or a knife. Correct, no? I am going to put a tick now. Is it right or wrong? You are going to tell me, children. It is wrong. Why? I have told you always, whenever you have say wrong, you should justify your answer. Why? You should sharpen your pencil with a sharpener. If you do with a blade, you will get hurt. We must not play with fire. True or false? True. Correct? Yes. We must cross the road at the zebra crossing. True or false? True. Right? So the first three sentences are true, false, and the last two sentences are true. We must run across the road? False. We must lean out of a moving bus? False. We should sharpen our pencils with a blade or a knife? False. That is wrong or not true. We must not play with fire? Correct. True. We must cross the road at the zebra crossing? Correct. Right, children? Now, let us go to the next question. Put a tick on the correct word. We must, in the bracket, there are two options, always or sometimes, follow rules for safety. Which is correct, children? Always. Every time you should follow rules of safety, not sometimes. Correct? We should light a match with or without the help of a grown-up. I told you this. We should take the help of a grown-up. So, with. We can play with a toy or pair of scissors. Which is correct? Which is the correct option, children? You are going to tell me now. I think we can play with a scissor. Correct? What will happen if you play with a pair of scissors? You will get hurt. So, it is a wrong option. So, the correct option is toy. We must cross the road at a traffic signal or zebra crossing. Which is correct? Zebra crossing. We must cross the road at the zebra crossing. We should wait for the bus to stop or start before we get onto it. What I have told you, always the bus should stop in the proper stop. Then only you can get in or what you have to do. Only when the bus stops, you have to get into the bus or get down from the bus. So the correct option is stop. So these are the correct options. Now let us go to the next question. That is, you have to look at this picture, children. See, it is very much clear in your textbook. So, all of you, please look at the picture and you have to say the answer. Fill in the blanks with words from the help box. Sorry, there is a help box where the answers are given. You have to pick and choose the correct option according to the sentence. So, first, let us see the first sentence. We must walk on the we must walk on the footpath. See, the option is there. The fourth option, footpath. We must walk on the footpath. So, you will write there, footpath. You can see the spelling also. It is given in the box. The second one, a dash is a sharp thing. What is a sharp thing? See from the box, what are the options given? The last one is knife. That is the fifth one. K-N-I-F-E, knife. A knife is a sharp thing. Now let us see the third question. When you want to light a candle, take the help of a grown-up. That is the third option. So you will write there, grown-up. The fourth question, We must not get on to a dash bus. On to a moving, that is the first option. We must not get on to a moving bus. And the last option, we must not dash on the road. We must not, you have to choose the second option. We must not play on the road. See, you have to look at the picture. In the picture you can see. You have to look at the picture and then answer these questions. Okay. Did you get, children? Yes or no? Yes. See, there is a picture also. You have to look at the picture. See, look at the picture and talk about what you should not do. What you will not do? You will not see the boys playing on the road. You should not do that. Yes, you should cross the road only at the zebra crossing. The boy is trying to board the bus, a moving bus. That you should not do. So these things you should not do. You can see in the picture. Right, children? So this was the textual questions. And the last question, as I told you, it is in the box. You have got the options. You have to choose the correct option and fill in the blanks, which already I have done. So these are the textual questions we have to do. Okay, children? So you can write these in the test book. If you have already done it along with teacher, it is okay. Otherwise, you can go through the video and you can copy the same. In the next session, we will do other notebook questions. Okay, children? So, bye-bye, children. Have a nice day. Thank you.